You have come to a course on data cleaning and data publishing. And this is a course that essentially melds two major topics. But as we planned out the curriculum, we came to feel like the two go quite well together. Essentially, as you work towards publishing a data set, which is to say, making it broadly available, ideally, you will have improved its quality. You will have sought out any errors. You will have either flagged those problematic records or corrected them. But essentially, data cleaning and data publishing should go together. So essentially, what we're setting out to do is address this idea of taking raw data and detecting, flagging, correcting, and managing errors, and improving and enriching the data. These are the things that can be added to raw data that will make them more useful. And the second objective is essentially to show you the basics of, now that you have an improved data set, how do you make that broadly available? And essentially, we have a week to communicate this information. It's not enough, but we at the very least have some very good experts here to walk you through this process, and we'll do our very best to answer any questions and solve any problems that emerge. So here are your instructors. Sorry, guys, if you don't like your pictures, but that's what was out there on the web. But essentially, we have four people whom I consider quite fundamental in this field of improving, correcting, and publishing biodiversity data sets. I'll let them introduce themselves a little more formally, if they so choose, but I had the pleasure of working with John Wieczorek for about 10 years, John. He was the lead technologist in the Ornis project, which I was the PI of, and so that was a very good excuse to work together for quite a while. Laura Russell is the VertNet programmer, which is to say she is funded by the US government to maintain vertebrate databases for the United States, which is to say maintain them published and openly and broadly available. Javier Otegui is a former doctoral student and a very good friend of mine. I actually got to meet him only last night, but he comes extremely highly recommended, and I've read several of his publications, so I have no doubt of those recommendations. And Kyle Braak, I actually met about 15 minutes ago, but he also comes quite well recommended. He's your title programmer at the GDO. Okay, so at the Global Biodiversity Information Facility in Copenhagen, which is one of the foci of biodiversity informatics activity around the world. So you have quite a good team of experts. And the very good news that I have for you is that as of one more presentation, I'm going to sit down and not talk again until Thursday. I'll leave you in very capable hands and you won't have to put up with me any longer. Our general plan for this course is that we will work together each day 9 to 5. I would ask you to arrive on the early side, so it would be 30:45, just so that we can start right on time at 9 a.m. That way we don't essentially eat into the first round of presentations. But essentially what we'll do is a couple hours of lectures, a half hour break, another hour and a half of lectures, and then an hour for lunch, which is just a very short walk from here. Another hour and a half of lectures, another break, and another hour of lectures. So essentially we're trying to break this up so that nobody, not the experts or the trainees, but nobody is essentially we'll try to break up the day for you. If you have any special needs as far as timing or just anything that you need particularly, talk to Kate or me. We'll do our very best to take care of your needs. And then last but not least, Kate and me. Kate's on the left. The girl on the right is my granddaughter. She would be a little too young to be of much help for you. But Kate is a doctoral student in ecology and evolutionary biology at the University of Kansas, and is the program assistant for this project for the next half year or so. So I think that's all there is as far as introducing the course. Any questions of a more practical nature about the accompanying data publishing?